I mentioned that Chen's only here for Injustice 2?
Oh yeah, for sure. Alright, plus frames now. Sweep, challenging right immediately. Again, with the patience to begin this set. Simple, effective, and an actual art form. It takes a lot to understand.
Nice. Down two.
Discipline is the word I'm looking for.
And I would agree with you.
Decent mix-ups this time. The meter burn back three and the instant air escape. Again, Chen loving to use his meter on defensive options. A lot of push blocks, a lot of air escapes, clashing. Not much in the meter burn department for anything. Just piece by piece. Right then.
Now, this is looking very similar to the game we saw earlier.
Yeah, actually building a lot of meter here if he continues his barrage of projectiles. But Dash is done three times. Puts himself in the precarious position now. Chen right in there.
Tries to get in, barely misses off of the leap, and that is going to be the life bar here for Krathan.
Yeah, very content with piece by piece. Back three. Zoning, no full combos, you don't need it. Wow, and a great swipe there.
Yeah, what he's been doing has worked. Oh, and this could be an opportunity. What's the mix? Oh, and he just, you see that, he just stared into his eyes.
Yeah, goes for the DP there, not sure what the option was. Looking for the mix up, Krathan walks out of it. Nice blocks. So much respect right now. At that time,
this should be very healthy damage and a kill. Yeah, 351. That's actually the highest damage we've seen Zhen do against Krathan so far this weekend.
Oh, catches him on the startup of the anti-air stars. Air escapes out, no punish, but instead keeps it close. What's it gonna be? Overheads?
Yes.
But he tries it again, but that wake up you were talking about, the jump back.
And reads the command grab this time. Full combo.
Nice.
Air escape.
And he tries to chase him down. No conversion off that down one. Could have had something, but even still, this is a very close first game.
Oh, cross up that time on the backside. Pounces to get out again. And meter burn back three keeps it unclashable with the overhead into the bomb. That is a combo. Oh, just out of the range now. Big time risk. What's
it
going to be?
Sweep three. Goes for the armor three. Delayed wake up, and that's going to do it.
Yes. Doesn't quite block the end of it. Might have chipped out, might not. Either way it goes, a win is a win.
There was an opportunity there for Zhen to make the comeback, but didn't quite get it.
To a fantastic delayed wake up there from Krathan, allowing Zhen to go right over his head. Grant himself an additional turn upon wake up, that down poke into that forward dive, letting all of the bullets fly. Dives in, checks him with the poke.
Getting caught by the meter bird. As we loop in again, we haven't seen any trade from Zhen.
All right, Max Reeves jumps over, baits out the anti-air a little too far with the pounce to make anything happen. Whiffing some normals now, in there, sweep.
And that's the risk that we haven't really seen from Zhen, but still down to no activation of the trait.
Would have been hard to get the combo continuation there. Instead, it goes directly into the pounce for the full combo now. Great overhead guns to keep him at bay. Checking him at every angle from every position on the screen is Krathan. The meter burn back three. A little too
late.
Yeah, Cheetah able to recover in time. Quick shot. Back dashes out. His minefield just everywhere. Goes for the command grab, but gets the hit on the down one, so it doesn't connect.
Switching sides. Krathan, nice presence of mind. Beautiful. Gotham Stars going upwards.
Locks
not enough.
Jumps in the instant overhead. There will be no reactant to this.
Oh, there we go. We're finally seeing the claws come out. Can he get something off of it?
Back three plus, plus,
plus,
ten.
Plus, plus. Look at all this chip damage. Slowly making it.
Oh, my
and
goodness.
And is he going to close it out? Oh, he leaps. Oh, that was beautiful.
And he had the right idea, but a little too much range on that escape from Red Hood. He's able to dive out. Cheetah trying to chase him down with a dive of her own, but instead falls just a little short. Tossing the beer. Red Hood, clearly not a drinker. Unaffected. Back two and a sweep to get the life bar.
I don't think he would be a huge trigger. Technically, he is a dead man, right? Brought back?
I mean, sure. He just wants to kill people. It's okay.
It's true. No, he does.
All right. Down two for the anti-air.
Misses.
Oh, and no punish there. Looking for the meter burn conversion. And that's always been a thing with the NRS game. Some characters have unsafe special moves that can be made safe during their meter burn conversion. So you end up expecting the meter burn they can get away with.
Yeah.
Just letting the raw punish go.
Oh, no punish there. And one thing I've actually noticed that's really starting to hurt Zhen, and I'm realizing now, especially thinking back in the first set, is he's going for these setups that are all off of a normal wake-up, and Kraven is almost exclusively doing delayed wake-ups.
All right, and the double forward three there to keep it unclashable. Ooh, looking for the instant overhead. Great block. Forward three into the back three, and through the streets we go.
Is that going to kill
him? Hey, Cheetah, I got a message for you. Oh, what's up? Through the skies, across the sky bridge, up top, and survives the fall with 8.66 percentage points of health.
Oh,
the command grab, and does he get the connection back three? Pounce.
Gets right under it. This is a crazy finish. Goes for the
jump. Oh, the backdash. What is happening?
Oh, my goodness, Shen.
The down one into the DP. Cheetah with the win.
Woo.
Stealing that one from
and
the clutch.
Look at Shen. He's just stone cold. Like, nothing just doesn't even affect
he
him.
He backdashed a dive. That was ridiculous.
That was godlike.
Double down one. Fighting from the clutches of defeat is Shen and the anti-air now tying up.
But one thing I want to say is that when he activated his trait, do you see how much damage he's doing on Shen? We need to see that more. And as I say that, there is a trait activation.
And whiffing some buttons now, sweeps it.
Nice backdash, beautiful stuff. Shen has really been picking his spots when those mines are out to know when he can press a button and when he can get out safely.
Krithin tosses the TV, not sure if Cheetah watches, but right now she's going to stay on the outside. Great zoning, keeping him honest, the overhead.
Oh, and he connects. Huge damage here. 500?
Can we talk about this? All right, that meter burn forward, three cancel.
Lightning. Oh, and he tried. Beautiful backdash.
Absolutely. Krithin swinging the momentum back in his favor now. Full combo into the mine setup. Yes. We're going to chase Cheetah down. Walk her down to the corner. No. Jumps back to avoid the pounce. And that's
okay. Staggers. Gets the backdash this time.
What a read. Meter burns it to get the extra hit of damage.
And down three.
Yes. All right, dives in now. Pulse. Keeps it safe. High attack and the instant overhead. Great air escape from Krithin.
That would have been some pretty healthy damage. Nice choice from Krithin. But
gets hit with by the ceiling fan. The interactable that you forget is even there.
We don't really get to see that often.
All right, Red Hood into the corner now. Down one. Great tree cancel. Back Shen into the corner now. Red Hood puts in work here.
Again,
bomb is out.
Knowing when to poke out. I really like that from Shen.
All right, the low into the restand plus 8 million.
The worst, didn't get full punish for that, although it was on whiff, so it is a little hard to punish.
All right, knockdown. Mine is out once again, follows it, but Shen with the perfect timing and a great delay wake up again. Krithin knows exactly when to do so.
Okay, gets the grab in the corner now. What's the mix? Doesn't block. Oh, huge damage.
Big trouble. Unclashable there at the end of that grab. In trouble. It's
and there it is now. We see Shen up.
The meter burn back three. Oh, there it is again. He rubbed the beard.
Yeah. You're right.
He rubbed the beard. Krithin is in trouble, but he has shown the poise last time when Shen was coming back, and he just did his thing. Yeah. I'm so confused.
Don't worry about what's happening.
It's all good. Storm is the god right now. We saw him able to close out a set. That's the same amount of pressure as being down, in my opinion.
But
when
you're
like 2-1 and someone's fighting back and the momentum is coming, you're able to put that
wall
up.
You're absolutely right. But again, he cannot deny Jan's ability to adapt. He's done it in multiple fighting games.
Sure.
And you know damn well that after he lost to Krithin, he was already thinking of ways to take him out if he fought him again. That is why we see him up a game now.
Yeah, but now he's down a life bar. Krithin with that meter burn back three at the right time. Keeping it out, Shen trying to backdash, and the air-to-air, fantastic reactions. Now it's Krithin who was in control, slowly filling the screen with all of his shenanigans. Red Hood making this circus of attacks.
This looks very strong from Krithin now. Very, very strong.
There. That was dominating round.
I can't get over how much I love the fact that Shen knows exactly when to poke, even when with a ticking mine right under him.
All right, this time the punish now on that instant overhead. Krithin was in fact ready in the early clash that lets you know his domination is going further than just on screen. It's also in Shen's head, and he wanted nothing to do with that setup or that combo.
And there is a sizable life lead on the side of Krithin, but we know how fast those can melt. And speaking about melting, look at this. 41 jumping in. Nice blocks. Goes low.
And the raw forward three. Ready to whiff punish the string there, but that big boot coming from Red Hood now into the combo. Has no clash. Now it's going to eat all of this. Krithin having his way. Dives in.
Yes. Peter burns it. On hit, a lot of extra chip there, getting in, and this
should be death. Restand into guarantee. What's the chip going to be? Is it
enough?
He's
just doing all the chip, yes. And there it is.
And a double slide. We are going into a decisive game five in this run back. Who is going to make top 16?
Again, this is huge. Whoever wins this moves on into top 16, and the loser is, they're done. Their tournament biennality is done.
Cheetah. Red little pause hood. Right there.
Hand
to the face is now. Kratos no longer rubbing his beard. Shen's gonna.
No, Zhen's kind of gonna, playing with his hair a little bit. You know, but I do really like how Zhen will go back to the character select screen. He will take his time and kind of think things over. And that's a viable trait to have. And we actually. There's a lot of players that don't do that. And they just hop right back in, and then you see a mess.
All right. And not expecting this down one to connect on hit. Doesn't get the command grab.
Excellent spacing again on that down three. That's been Shen's strong point.
Three to get the back dash. Yes.
Again.
Yeah, he's looking to mix up heavy this game right now. Wants to catch Kratos blocking. However, hasn't gotten the respect just yet. Into the interactable. Great air escape, so he doesn't eat that back three.
Those are unblockable interactables as well. In fact, I think the stage has the most unblockable interactables.
All right, getting mixed up. Cheetah's so elegant in the way she moves. So
Zhen is
slick.
Now up a life bar. All of this damage that he now gets is free. This is, and what I mean by free damage is as he sits on his second life bar, it's still Kratos' responsibility to take that out while all the damage that's put onto Kratos, this is it. This is all he has
in
left.
Big time trouble. Now the momentum has shifted far in
Zhen's
favor.
And there's the trait. Raw trait for Zhen. May not get to use it at all, though, as we see this combo in the corner.
And there's the drop. Again, we talk about momentum.
Unblockable.
Slams in on him, driving away in. Challenges the pounce now. Sweep, sweep. Plus
so
frame.
Close. Going for a second. Nice whip punish. Kratos should be able to take the life bar here, and he does. But look at how little life he has left. 236.
Now, Kratos still has access to a clash. However, Shen equal on meter. Here's the pounce into it. Backdash is out. No whip punish.
Trait. Oh, those down threes are hurting. That was 122 damage for a down three.
Right now, Kratos trying to find his way in.
And armor back three, that
back
is it!
Three. Yes, that is it. Shen advances to the top.
Okay, gets the grab in the corner now. What's the mix? Doesn't block. Oh, huge damage.
Big trouble. Unclashable there at the end of that grab. In trouble. It's
and there it is now. We see Shen up.
The meter burn back three. Oh, there it is again. He rubbed the beard.
Yeah. You're right.
He rubbed the beard. Kratos is in trouble, but he has shown the poise last time when Shen was coming back. And he just did his thing. Yeah. I'm so confused.
Don't worry about what's happening.
It's all good. Storm is the god right now. We saw him able to close out a set. That's the same amount of pressure as being down, in my opinion.
But
when
you're
like 2-1 and someone's fighting back and the momentum is coming, you're able to put that
wall
up.
You're absolutely right. But again, he cannot deny Zhen's ability to adapt. He's done it in multiple fighting games.
Sure.
And you know damn well that after he lost to Kratos, he was already thinking of ways to take him out if he fought him again. And that is why we see him up a game now.
Yeah, but now he's down a life bar. Kratos with that meter burn back three at the right time. Keeping it out, Zhen trying to backdash, and the air-to-air, fantastic reactions. Now it's Kratos who was in control, slowly filling the screen with all of his shenanigans. Red Hood making this circus of attacks.
This looks very strong from Kratos now. Very, very strong.
There. That was dominating round.
I can't get over how much I love the fact that Shen knows exactly when to poke, even when with a ticking mind right under him.
All right, this time the punish now on that instant overhead. Kratos was in fact ready in the early clash. That lets you know his domination is going further than just on screen. It's also in Shen's head, and he wanted nothing to do with that setup or that combo.
And there is a sizable life lead on the side of Kratos, but we know how fast those can melt. And speaking about melting, look at this. 41 jumping in. Nice blocks. Goes low.
Wow. The raw forward three. Ready to whip punish the string there, but that big boot coming from Red Hood now into the combo. Has no clash. Now it's going to eat all of this. Kratos having his way. Dives in.
Yes. Peter burns it. On hit, a lot of extra chip there, getting in, and this
should be death. Restand into guarantee. What's the chip gonna be? Is it enough?
He's just doing all the chip, and there it is.
And a double slide. We are going into a decisive game five in this run back. Who is going to make top 16?
This is huge. Whoever wins this moves on into top 16, and the loser is they're done. Their tournament biennality is done.
Cheetah. Little pause right there. Hands to the face is now. Kraithen's no longer rubbing his beard. Shen's kind of playing
with his hair a little bit. You know, but I do really like how Shen will go
screen with all of his shenanigans. Red Hood making this circus of attacks.
This looks very strong from Kraithen now. Very, very strong.
There. That was dominating round.
I can't get over how much I love the fact that Shen knows exactly when to poke, even when with a ticking mind right under him.
All right, this time the punish now on that instant overhead. Kraithen was in fact ready in the early clash that lets you know his domination is going further than just on screen. It's also in Shen's head, and he wanted nothing to do with that setup or that combo.
And there is a sizable life lead on the side of Kraithen, but we know how fast those can melt. And speaking about melting, look at this, 41 jumping in, nice blocks, goes low.
Wow! The raw forward three, ready to whip punish the string there, but that big boot coming from Red Hood now into the combo. Has no clash, now it's going to eat all of this. Kraithen having his way, dives in.
Yes. Peter burns it. On hit, a lot of extra chip there, getting in, and this
should be death. Restand into guarantee. What's the chip gonna be? Is it
just
enough?
Doing all the chip?
Yes.
And there it is.
And a double slide. We are going into a decisive game five in this run back. Who is gonna make top 16?
This is huge. Whoever wins this moves on into top 16, and the loser is they're done. Their tournament biennality is done.
Cheetah. Little pause right there.
Hands
to the face is now. Kraithen's no longer rubbing his beard. Shen's kind of playing
with his hair a little bit. You know, but I do really like how Shen will go back to the character select screen. He will take his time and kind of think things over. And that's a viable trait to have. And we actually, there's a lot of players that don't do that. And they just hop right back in and then you see a mess.
All right. And not expecting this down one to connect on hit. Doesn't get the command grab.
Excellent spacing again on that down three. That's been Shen's strong point.
Reads the backdash. Yes.
Again.
Yeah, he's looking to mix up heavy this game right now. Wants to catch Kraithen blocking. However, hasn't gotten the respect just yet. Into the interactable. Great air escape, so he doesn't eat that back three.
Those are unblockable interactables as well. In fact, I think the stage has the most unblockable interactables.
All right, getting mixed up. Cheetah's so elegant in the way she moves. So
Shen is
slick.
Now up a life bar. All of this damage that he now gets is free. And what I mean by free damage is as he sits on his second life bar, it's still Kraithen's responsibility to take that out while all the damage that's put onto Kraithen, this is it. This is all he has left.
Big time trouble. Now the momentum has shifted far
and
in Shen's
favor. And there's the trait. Raw trait for Shen. He may not get to use it at all, though, as we see this combo in the corner.
And there's the drop. Again, we talk about momentum.
Unblockable. And that's going to do it.
Yes. Doesn't quite block the end of it. Might have chipped out. Might not. Either way it goes, a win is a win.
There was an opportunity there for Shen to make the comeback, but didn't quite get it.
To a fantastic delayed wake-up there from Kraithen, allowing Shen to go right over his head. Grant himself an additional turn upon wake up, that down poke into that forward dive, letting all of the bullets fly. Dives in, checks him with the poke.
Getting caught by the meter bird. As we loop in again, we haven't seen any trade from Shen.
Hey, Max Reeves jumps over, baits out the anti-air a little too far with the pounce to make anything happen. Whiffing some normals now in there, sweep.
And that's the risk that we haven't really seen from Shen, but still down to no activation of the trait.
Would have been hard to get the combo continuation there. Instead, goes directly into the pounce for the full combo now. Great overhead guns to keep him at bay. Checking him at every angle from every position on the screen is Kraithen. The meter burn back three. A little
gets
too
the block,
late. Yeah, Cheetah able to recover in time. Quick shot. Back dashes out. His mind field just everywhere. Goes for the command grab, but gets the hit on the down one, so it doesn't connect.
Switching sides. Kraithen, nice presence of mind. Beautiful. Gotham Stars going upwards.
Locks not enough.
Jumps in the instant overhead. There will be no reaction to this.
Oh, sir. There we go. We're finally seeing the claws come out. Can he get something off of it?
Back three plus. Plus,
plus,
ten.
Plus, plus. Look at all this chip damage. Slowly making it.
Oh, my
and
goodness.
He, is he going to close it out? Oh, he leaps. Oh, that was beautiful.
And he had the right idea, but yeah. A little too much range on that escape from Red Hood. He's able to dive out. Cheetah trying to chase him down with a dive of her own, but instead falls just a little short. Tossing the beer. Red Hood clearly not a drinker. Unaffected. Back two and a sweep to get the life bar.
I don't think he would be a huge trigger. Technically, he is a dead man, right? Brought back.
I mean, sure. He just wants to kill people. It's okay.
It's true. No, he does.
All right. Down two for the anti-air.
Misses.
Oh, and no punish there. Looking for the meter burn conversion. And that's always been a thing with the NRS game. Some characters have unsafe special moves that can be made safe during their meter burn conversion. So you end up expecting the meter burn they can get away with.
Yeah.
Just letting the raw punish go.
Oh, no punish there. And one thing I've actually noticed that's really starting to hurt Jen, and I'm realizing now, especially thinking back in the first set, is he's going for these setups that are all off of a normal wake-up, and Kraven is almost exclusively doing delayed wake-ups.
All right, and the double forward three there to keep it unclashable. Ooh, looking for the instant overhead. Great block. Forward three into the back three, and through the streets we go.
Is that going to kill?
Hey, Cheetah, I got a message for you. Oh, what's up? Through the skies, across the sky bridge. Up